Hi guys, welcome back to my channel Prince Ink Pens. This is Prince and today I am going to review the Luoshi number 9808 fountain pen. So let's have a quick look and then we will have some writing samples and then I'll tell the things which I like about it and the things which I don't like about it. So the clip is somewhat inspired by the Lamy Safari. The nib is inspired by Lamy Safari, is the same folded style nib. So I think you may put an Lamy nib upon this section and use it. And if you see the section, it has triangular grip like the Lamy. And it is a forced grip. So now let's have a look at the pen. It looks same as the Twisby Eco and it is the knockoff of the Twisby Eco fountain pen. It has the piston mechanism which works well. So now let's ink this pen up. So today I am going to ink this pen with Brill Royal Blue. So just screw in the piston, dip it in the ink and then pull the piston up. So yeah, you can do this repeatedly to draw more ink. But for this review, this much ink is sufficient. So I'll wipe the pen and the nib with a cloth. And now let's have a quick writing sample. So the pen here is Luoshi and the ink is Brill Royal Blue. So let's have a writing sample. So you can see the writing is pretty fine and as this nib is extra fine, the writing is proper according to the nib size. So let's have a fast writing sample. Yeah, as you can see the feed keeps up pretty well with this ink and the paper is also pretty fine. Let's try reverse writing. So as you can see, it reverse writes, but there are skips in the writing and also the line becomes ultra extra fine and it is not good for daily usage. So let's check the wetness of the nib. So considering that it is an extra fine nib, the wetness of the nib is fine. And so let's check whether it has any amount of flex to it. So as you can see, there is no amount of flex to it and from this folded nib design, you cannot expect any flex. So now let's check the line width. So as you can see, there is very less line variation and also it is not advertised as a flex nib and I won't call it a flex nib. But As you can see, it holds a pretty good amount of ink. If you have a full ink bottle, you can fill it pretty well. And also, I like the design of the pen. And I am not a huge fan of the forced grip, but in this pen, the forced grip is pretty well, and I like the forced grip in this pen. So, this pen and ink combination is pretty good. And the paper is pretty smooth too. And you can get a good writing sample and writing experience with this nib. And some people may feel it scratchy as extra fine. But for the price it's worth. It is just 70 rupees, which is about $1. And it is pretty good. It writes pretty well. And also you can see the nib. The nib is designed pretty well. It has the Luoshi branding upon it. And this is a Chinese fountain pen. And I don't have any information about the company as it is not very famous. So, I got it in the lime green color. And as many Twist Bees, they have this red funnel. And even this pen has the same thing. But it doesn't have the same logo. And also, I will make a video soon upon how to disassemble this pen. So, let's see a video tomorrow. You will be getting a video tomorrow. So thank you. And please don't subscribe. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And also consider liking this video and sharing it with your friends. Thank you. The cap posts pretty well. But it is not good for using posted as it becomes too long. And then it is pretty long sized. And you won't be comfortable. But without posting also, it has a good amount of length and you can write unposted with it.